my little crystals. This is location number 6 TE review. About to give you the real tea on next door restaurant in New Haven, Connecticut. Let's go.
All right, I think we're in the clear. We're here at next door.
Ooh, this is great. The pizza guys at work, and this is
for private events too.
Awesome.
So we close this off for graduation parties.
Hello.
Yeah, so I'm gonna
sit you
over there so we can be as loud as possible.
Approved. Rainbow
Planet Rainbow Pizza. Stars. Yeah, right here.
All right, cool. Thank you.
All right, let me bring you some menu.
Okay.
Blown away because I didn't expect it to be this big, and on top of it, it's so hip. We're in Connecticut. Next door.
This is our regular food menu here. You can make your own pizzas, and we also have suggestions of our versions of what we think fits the best.
Okay.
Wine, all kinds of craft cocktails, wine flights, beer flights, non-alcoholic beverages. We also have like mocktails, which are fun. The draft list, we have 32 beers on draft. We focus mainly on local craft beers.
Local, we're all about local.
All about the local, that's right. And then we have many more cans and bottles. So we have plenty of literature for people to look through when they first come here.
This is incredible though. This is so cool.
And then to top it off, we have specials as well. Doug, the owner of the Big Green Truck, started this restaurant with Robin Bodak, who's a local chef. And so Robin takes care of everything that has to do with the kitchen, all these fries. We have fries poutine style, mac and cheese, snacks and pieces, which are just little bites of things, and then small plates. So the way that the menu is designed is really to be shared.
Yes.
So you order a few of the small plates, the snacks, things like that. Well, this menu is also very friendly if you are vegan or just dairy free. So I'm gonna pick a few things.
Yeah,
and
this surprise
if you guys want a couple of drinks, choose that.
Okay, I'll choose
your drink.
Deal.
Okay.
That's what I will do. Thank you.
So much energy. I'll give you guys an update of how I'm feeling. I'm exhausted from just like the move and just working a lot and the transition. It's great and I'm so excited, but your boy's a little tired, and I'll tell you right now, walking in here, I feel like I just drank a Red Bull. I feel alive. It's very great customer service already because the hospitality in here is through the roof. Another waitress just came over and checked on us to make sure that we didn't want to order anything, which I love because we're not being unintended.
Hi, how are you? So give your little review so far.
My review?
Yeah, you look great.
Do I?
Yeah.
So I can't wait to eat.
So, I mean, for my suggestion would be the sage advice is amazing because it's also a little bit of aromatherapy, which
sage
I know.
Sage advice, yes.
Sage advice, okay.
How about you?
Oh God.
What are you feeling? What type of liquor do you like?
Tequila.
Okay, we have a citrus margarita that's fantastic. It's all winter citruses, so it's kumquat.
Kumquat, okay. I'm in! Look how amazing.
All right guys, here's the citrus margarita.
Oh my goodness.
And the sage advice.
Actually, the energy already feels really good in here, so I don't think you guys need any sage. Yeah.
We actually do sage the place every month.
That's why it feels so good. Talk about seeing spirit.
It smells incredible. Almost like I just got out of the spa. Ooh.
Thoughts.
It's like soothing, but if I can tell you guys what it just felt like, it almost just felt like I was with a shaman and he just gave me a shot down my throat of like some like shit that Chelsea Wheatley's drinking.
So yours is a reposado tequila. And it's got orange, lime. At the top is a salted kumquat. It's a type of citrus. It's a winter citrus, so it grows in the winter.
Oh no, I like it because it's salty.
I might be a little tipsy just from that one sip. I'm not gonna put up a front. I also weigh 3 pounds, so maybe that's it. Ooh,
yeah.
I like this because it tastes like an actual margarita. Ooh.
So these are spicy Brussels sprouts, and they got a little ricotta dollop.
Oh, I love Brussels sprouts. Yes.
Well, I haven't even tasted the food, but if it's good, I'm going to be back already. I know it. Okay, so from the GM herself, she's gonna tell you really quick basically, we're going to be trying all the top favorites here at Next Door.
Right.
Right?
So first up is the sweet and spicy Brussels sprouts. They're like candied vegetable.
Drum roll, please. Okay, don't know if this flower is edible, but we're going for it because it's so cute.
You just destroy
it. That's how you gotta do it, though. You really have to go for it. If you don't, it's one bite, guys. It's one bite. I lied. I'm gonna do one more bite. Wow. So it has like this aftertaste that has like this like smoky candy, but a little bit of like spice to it. I don't know what that spice is, but it's not like buffalo chicken, like, oh my god, it's so hot. It's just like, it's just enough. I feel like that's a common theme so far between the hospitality, the drinks. It's not overbearing. It's just enough everything. The salt, margarita, it's just enough. The sage, bite number 4. 10 out of 10. My mom loves Brussels sprouts. I've never had something like this before. The ricotta cheese too, or the ricotta. Oh my god. I'm gonna keep it real. I think a fig would be good in this. I don't know, something like a fig would be so good in this. Other than that, I'll rate this first one an 8.8 out of 10 because Brussels sprouts are hard to do, but I feel like it's missing a fig. Oh. The cheese is what makes it. I love the cheese. Dirty, so good. I'm gonna change the review. Let's change up. 9.3. Has to go up a little more because this will go out too. And the flowers. 9.6. 9.6 out of 10. 0.4 deducted. No fig. Next!
Door.
So how do I feel about these?
So good. Yeah. I said the only critique I had was I feel like it's just missing a slice of like a fig.
Oh yeah.
It's a fig. Yeah. That's it.
Yeah.
I gave 0.4 off for no fig. It has a little kick into it. What's the kick?
Yeah, so it's spicy. It's got a little kick.
But it's not like,
It's a lepo pepper.
This is all new. You are teaching me tonight. I feel like I'm in school. I'm like,
yeah. Robin is big into the things that nobody else uses, really.
Which is key. Which TE loves, because that's how it should be.
Oh my god.
The neck one, my foot bone. It is full of life in here. It feels so wholesome. It feels very uplifting. I feel uplifted, and I feel like I was very tired before. Now I'm just like, get even their napkins. Like, what? This is like a $5 napkin.
Oh. All right, these are short rib fries.
I literally just
Short rib fries. Why does everything, you guys are like, oh, this is the short rib fries, and then it comes over and it's like straight up, like out of a magazine. Like, I feel like I don't even want to touch it. It's like very high Vogue. Like, this looks like straight up Vogue.
Yeah, Robin puts a lot of thought into the plating, which is why we actually don't do any of this food to go, because it just wouldn't travel the same way. And it's also about the way that the chef artist wants to present it. You know, I mean, they want you to experience not just how it's plated, but they want you to experience it here in this space. So
I've been to plenty of places, and I gotta say, this is something, everything that you meant bringing me, different. I've never seen something like this.
Yes, awesome.
But it's like American tapas. Round number 2. Shorty. Here we go. Okay. Well, I missed the meat on that one, so that didn't count. This is what it looks like. Bigger than my head. Here we go. The meat tastes like butter. What has that been in? That was the most delicious piece of meat I've had in a long time. I understand why the chef now does not do takeout work. Cause this shit is too good. Like, my ass is driving to come get this shit. Like, I don't care if there's no takeout. It's that good. My ass will come here and get this shit. Let me try it with the tomato. try with tomato. Here we go. Tomato bite. Wow, well, even with the spino, you know, game changer. 10, this is at the 10. I never had something like this before. The presentation, the taste, the meat, I don't know how they did it. I really don't know how they did it. Okay, I need to stop eating because this is literally almost done. And my little tiny stomach is not gonna be able to finish all this food. And the tomato, there's one more bite, like so good, dude. What is this? Crack? Cocaine? I feel very like at home here. I really do already because like any type of energy artist should be welcomed with a cocktail that has sage in it. And also, I am welcomed in an area that's already been pre-staged. So I feel very lucky and blessed and grateful that they have this type of respect to the spiritual world. Not a lot of people do. Update. I took like 2 sips of this, and I'm telling you right now, they make these drinks very strong, and I might have to call an Uber because I didn't even realize I was drinking alcohol. I like a place that has, like, they stick to a good drink in the sense of I don't like when places measure out to a T of how much alcohol they're putting in it. This just tastes like good energy. Like, I just feel like the bartender was just like, do. Like, Ratatouille, he just knew what to put in it, and it came about, but this is definitely straight up 100% alcohol.
Are we ready?
We're ready. I'm, like, getting full of
this. So how did you feel about that?
They got
so
a 10.
Good. Oh my god.
They
so
got a 10.
Freaking so good.
The knife is literally jumping out. That's how much.
Alright, so this is the pink salad. And you'll see it here. It's actually one of our specials. So I wanted to give you something that isn't regularly on our menu.
Pink is my favorite color.
Also, okay. I didn't know that.
And also, my aura is pink. So that's crazy.
Cool.
She feels it. Pink salad?
The pink salad. So it's speckled radicchio, hidden rose apple, Point Reyes farmstead blue cheese, pignoli brittle, which is my favorite. So these are like crispy pignoli nuts, basil, and cider vinaigrette.
Ooh,
very good. Dig in.
Okay, amazing. Thank you. I can't even believe you guys priced it. I feel like they should be.
I know, and I think that surprises a lot of people because they think downtown New Haven, or you come to New Haven and you think, oh, I'm going to spend a lot of money. And really, especially with a big group of people, sometimes it's shocking to me. People walk out of here with like $15 a head, $20 a head, and they had a buffet of just incredible.
Guys, that's
food.
How much like McDonald's is. If you think about it for
yeah,
real,
it
you get a large of McDonald's. I'm not kidding because you know I love Mickey D's.
Yeah.
I always get the Big Mac. It's like $11, $12.
Yeah.
Spend $3 more.
Yeah.
Here no, but serious.
And support local, you know?
And support local. I don't even want to eat these plates because they're so pretty. You know what I mean? Out of all my years of living, I've never had a pink salad. So let's see what this tastes like. It's pink. I wonder how they get the pink lettuce. Is it like dyed? Is it not dyed? Straight up pink. She's a pink bitch. Pink apple. The pignoli. A little bit of gorgonzola, I think. Some fucking herb shit. TE is part rabbit.
I'm sorry, guys.
I love salad.
Come out. And the pizza has to be served hot.
Let's do it. Like part rabbit.
Oh, really?
Well, my mom is. Really, I'm dead. I'm straight up. Straight up. It's so crazy because I feel like all these flavors are different. It's so different.
Yeah.
It's not your next door place, even though it's called next door.
It's not your average pizza joint, is what
it's
we say.
It's not. It is not.
Look at this thing.
So wait, what's this?
Okay,
this is
so,
round number 4. We're
right,
being spoiled.
So
tonight.
I had to do the mashed potato, because it's our classic.
Ooh,
yeah, so I did half and half, which is awesome. Not all pizza places will let you do half and half. We do them with our large pies. You can get any topping on each half or whatever. You can do our pies half and half. So this is our classic mashed potato with caramelized onions, bacon, and the mashed potato is like grandma made mashed potato. It's got lots of butter, like
we'll see if it compares to Nanny. Let's see, Nanny, yeah. My grandma Nanny.
And then on this side you have the fresh tomato, which has pesto basil puree.
Every time we order pizza, we either get broccoli or tomato basil. We're like, margarita. And I already could tell I'm gonna like this because I love crispy bacon. I hate when you go to places and you get the bacon and it's like raw.
Well, what's interesting about this is like it's thick and it's crispy. So it's interesting.
It is interesting. The cheerleader in me is being a little aggressive tonight. Don't know what's in the stage strength, but I'll tell you right now, be aggressive, be aggressive, and where's the music? Is it the music? Like, I choked. Round number four. I'm gonna start with the mashed potato. Is it better than my grandmother's mashed potato? The crust, super thin. I love that it's a brick oven. Every place should be cooking pizza in a brick oven. That's how pizza is meant to be cooked. And what I like too, you guys, so thin. Thin like my rock band, like my ring. This is like perfect golden brown, not burnt. Okay. I like this better. Even though this is incredible, because this does really taste, the mashed potatoes are very like creamy, buttery, really good. But this. Yes. 10, 9.7. Next door. Variety, there. Different ingredients, there. American food, there. Friendly for everybody. Every type of eater, whether you are a meat eater, a veg head, they have really everything. So overall, not being biased, because you know I have to keep it motherfucking real, this place, I would rate this overall a 9.2. I'm gonna take 0.8 away for a couple things. 0.4, no fig or type of like citrus or like fruity tang. And then another 0.3 off for not having a energy painting in here when they're literally sage and they literally have the sage strength. Like, this is meant to have a TE painting. Like, I feel like a really cool energy painting maybe for them would be like all like old doors, and I get all doors from like all vintage like vocal businesses, and I make a really cool energy painting out of doors. Like, that would be something I feel like would be really cool for this place.
A little nervous. Here we go.
Pressure's on, boys. Here we go.
Okay.
Do I have to stretch?
This is Michael.
No, should I wash my hands really quick? Are we okay? Yeah. Let me wash this. Be a little. I like being cleansed.
So, I've also worked at a pizza restaurant before. I worked at Eli's up inside.
Small, so it doesn't have to be that big.
I'm really getting in this. Here I am at next door. So this is the sauce.
They have no idea what you're doing.
I feel
doing.
Like I'm dreaming right now. This doesn't even seem real. And I'm guessing they do like this technique. You know, like I'm feeling that. I kind of went a little, ooh. And then maybe leave enough room for the crust. How's that look?
I'll go a little bit closer to the edges.
A
little closer?
A
little closer.
Professional. Straight up professional. Mama loves color, so let's do color. I always say this round, see? Moose or moss?
Moose.
I'm always like, yeah, you want a mozzarella? You got it.
Which one do you want?
Moose.
Moose. do a pizza class once a month, so I feel like we're doing
really?
Pizza class.
Oh my
pizza
god!
Pizza class!
No way!
I know where I'm having my birthday.
I know.
Okay, so let's put some color on it because I love color. I love a good pepper. What goes good with pepper?
Sausage.
You got the andouille? Raw, we're not trying to get any salmonella. A little black pepper. And this is not just any black pepper. Or is it?
No.
It's
Himalayan.
It's Himalayan. Okay, so it's on the board. Thank God I did my push-ups tonight.
That's it.
Am I hired? Pretty good? So TE is actually quitting his day job as an artist, and I will be here at next door. Is this the bit, the owner?
Yeah.
This is amazing to meet you. You never meet the owner at places, you guys. This is like,
sure.
You look like the owner, too. I need your outfit.
I try and do that. This is $15. Good deal.
He is my type of dude. Bargain shopper. I did not expect this. I didn't even know I was going to get the full tour.
Hello, everyone.
Oh, this is incredible.
So now, this is where it all started. This was, we call it a restaurant next door because, as you see, it's literally next door to this. And we have a total of 5 of these trucks. They are all genuine antiques. The woodwork gets taken off of them and sanded down and then repainted.
These are beautiful.
And
these are so...
Here's the oven on each of the trucks. And I don't know, have you seen the trucks in action?
No.
Oh, okay. Well, they arrive with some wood panels.
An oven in a truck.
An oven in a truck.
And not just any type of truck, guys. This is like an antique.
Yeah.
This is straight up antique. This is a piece of art in itself.
Yeah. Those panels lift off and become tables that we set up alongside the truck. We pull out a bunch of toppings, put them on one of the pizza tables, and start making pizzas right in front of people. Bake them off in the oven here.
You pick what you want.
That
is incredible. That is, guys, I've heard of pizza trucks, but nothing like this level.
The first two had the oven in the center and a cutout sort of stencil of the tomatoes.
One during the day, one during night?
Yeah. A lunch and a dinner 5 times, so we're doing 40 to 50 parties.
Woo!
A week.
Okay. Yeah. I didn't hang out with you guys more. I'm into partying.
Well,
I like
there
that.
You go. Cool.
Thank you.
Enjoy.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Hello.
So cool.
You can ask the health department the cleanest kitchen they've ever seen. Well, guys, this is where I love you and leave you.
Yes, thank you. Oh, it was a pleasure.
Bye, guys.
You guys out February 2nd.
Terrible review.
Thank you. Your drinks are amazing.
Thank you.
First experience here at Next Door. Woohoo! I have to give the review a little bit up a notch because the whole time, the atmosphere, the ambience, the people there, the workers, everything is so authentic, everything is so genuine, everything is so real, everything is so local. They are the real deal. I'm changing it. Overall rating of Next Door is a 9.998. Yeah. Only thing I gotta say is I'm gonna take 0.1 off because you don't have an energy painting. Doors.
Take the pizza.
Take this one. Right,
love you.
Okay, just gave my sister my pizza I made. I made that. Get any better? Okay, new rating. This has officially gotten a 10. This place is a 10. Honestly, fuck the energy. Are you kidding me? How do you feel?
I need to buy one of those
sweatshirts. We're getting all new apparel. There's like, I don't know. I just feel like we're so aligned.
You know, it's so crazy. I'm obsessed with that story and. All-